Hello class.
Now till here we have studied what is the meaning of system, what is the meaning of boundary, what is the meaning of surrounding, and what is the meaning of universe. Now we will go further in detail the types of system. Okay, so the basically the system are classified on the basis of how the flow of mass, heat and work are take place across the boundary. I told you the boundary is the thing which keeping system different from surrounding, or which is enveloping a system, okay, or we can say which is isolating a system from surrounding, and that boundary may be real or hypothetical. Okay, so on the basis of mass transfer, on the basis of heat energy transfer, and on the basis of work transfer across the boundary in between system and surrounding, the system get classified. Okay, so there are basically three type of system exist. One is the open system, which is also called as a control volume system or flow system. Second is a closed system, which is also called as a control mass system or non-flow system. Okay, and third one is the isolated system. Okay, so the closed system further get classified into two types. One is the insulated system or non-insulated system. So let's start to understand the first kind of system, that is open system, or we can say control volume system or flow system. Okay, so just take example. This first example I have quoted here. So this is a one test tube I like to show you on the slide. Okay, and here another one beaker is there. Okay, so this test tube are halfly filled with the red color liquid and halfly filled with the air. Okay, and this test tube is open, no any lead is present at the top. Means I mean to say here this test tube is not closed by any kind of that lead on or it. Okay, so it is open. The boundary at that top region is hypothetical. Okay, so if we describe the system, then it is only that much only. So whatever the thing present, volume present or mass present inside this test tube is our system. So that is mass of this air plus mass of this red color liquid is making a system. Okay, and after that what will happen whenever this testing I have kept in a sunlight, that time what happened, whatever the liquid present over here start to evaporate due to the sunlight, and it start to escaping out from that system, it crossing the boundary. Means here what will happen, the mass of water that liquid get decreasing and the mass of air is increasing. As soon as the vapor of this liquid get out of that test tube, the equal mass of or equal volume of air will enter to the test tube. So here liquid are going out of the test tube, which is present inside the test, which is present already inside the test tube, and at that place a fresh air will enter to the test tube. So here mass exchange are take place across the boundary in between system and surrounding. It is about the mass. Now consider this liquid present inside the tube is heated at 100 degrees Celsius. Then what will happen? The heat energy content by this 100 degrees Celsius liquid also try to escape out from that system. Whatever the air present over here inside the test tube are also absorb this heat from this liquid, but it is inside the boundary. But whenever this air transferring the heat energy, the adjacent air present outside the boundary, outside the boundary. The heat get transfer across the system, okay, across the boundary in between system and surrounding. So in that way, work in that way, heat transfer will take place. In that way, mass transfer will take place across the boundary, and whenever work also get transferred across the boundary, that time such a system are called as a open system. Okay, so one thing here need to be noticed that it is not like that here. The no any kind of work done is take place here. Okay, so it's not necessary. If work transfer are not take place across the boundary, it doesn't mean it is open system. If mass and heat transfer take place across the boundary, then that system can be called as a open system. Okay, as here no any lead is present over the this test tube, we can say it is an open system. The same way here here another image is shown. In the beaker, water is present and someone throws a ball inside this beaker. So that time, whatever the water present in the beaker, it spill out. Okay, and for as soon as it spill out, what will happen? Mass get transfer across the boundary to the surrounding. So mass get transfer in between system and surrounding across the boundary. So here mass exchanges take place. This whatever the radiation coming from the sun are get absorbed that water, and whenever is at the position of sun, when moon will come, that water start to radiate that heat, whatever it get absorbed during the daytime. So that time what will happen? Heat get change crosses the boundary and it enter to the surrounding. Okay, at night time. So here, in case of the open system, what will happen? Mass and heat can exchange across the boundary in between system and surrounding. So this is a type of, this is a example of open system. And think it need to be noticed here, if it is not here also, no any kind of work done is take place. Okay, if we think at a microstate level, the displacement of ball can be called as a work done, but we are not interested in that system. We are only interested in the system which is present inside this beaker. Okay, so this is our system. So here we are not thinking for the work done. So whenever work is doing or not doing, it is doesn't mean whether it is open or not, open system or other kind of system. So here it is a only define or only describe on the basis of work, on the basis of mass transfer, and on the basis of heat energy transfer. Whenever heat transfer across the boundary to the surrounding or surrounding to system, whenever mass transfer from system to surrounding or surrounding to system across the boundary, then such a type of system is called as an open system. Now we'll see closed system. Now here what I did, here the test tube is open. Now in this case I have one tap on it. Okay, I have one cap on it. Whenever I put a cap on this test tube, whatever the mass present inside this test tube will not leave the system. Okay, it will not leave the system. Even whatever the mass of air present outside the system, that is inside this, that is at the surrounding, will not enter to the system. So mass transfer across the boundary is restricted here. Okay, now what will happen? Is it open system? No, as cap is closed, so what will happen? It is a closed system. Now consider for our heat transfer. Now this test tube, again take the example, this liquid get heated at 100 degrees Celsius, and what will happen whenever you are supposed to hold that 100 degrees Celsius heated water test tube by your naked hand, then you're supposed to feel that temperature. Okay, you're supposed to feel that heat at your palm. So what is that? This is the transfer of heat across the physical boundary. So heat transfer is there until and unless this tube is not insulated properly. You're supposed to feel that heat whenever this test tube hold by your hand. Okay, so this is a transfer of what? Heat across the boundary with your body. Now your body is a surrounding here. Okay, whenever I putting this hot water carrying test tube in the cold water, then what will happen? Heat get transfer from this hot water to cold water across this physical boundary. So there is a transfer of heat, but it is not like that. This water get mixed with the cold water. Mass will not transfer, only heat energy get transfer in that case. So what is this? This is a closed system. So whenever only heat energy get transfer across the boundary, okay, that time you can say it is a closed system. Mass will not transfer. And in this case of the closed system also, work can transfer across the boundary. In case of the open system, work can transfer, heat can transfer, mass can transfer. But in case of the closed system, mass will not transfer the boundary, work can transfer and heat can transfer. So such a system is called as a closed system. Now come to the isolated system. Now this is an isolated system. Okay, so it is isolated, not insulated. Okay, it is a isolated, not a insulated. So difference is there. Whenever isolated is there, it means this system is isolated such way no kind of work transfer is take place, no kind of heat transfer is take place, and no any kind of mass transfer is take place across the boundary in between system and surrounding. Understand? Whenever I am talking about isolated system, it is such a system this in which no kind of any work get transfer, no any kind of matter get transfer, that is mass get transfer across the boundary, no any kind of heat energy get transferred across the boundary. So this system is perfectly isolated from the surrounding for a transfer of heat, for a transfer of work, and for a transfer of mass. Okay, so work, heat and mass both are not possible to transfer across the boundary in case of the isolated system. Now you will ask me, it is also called as an insulated system? No, insulated, it is a one of the characteristics which this system hold, that is insulation. Okay, which is shown over here. This test tube is put inside the insulated material. Okay, so one of the characters it hold, that is insulation, but we can't say it is a pure insulated system because it also not eligible to transfer work across the boundary. Here in case of the open system, I told you there is a two classification, insulation and non-insulation. So here I can say if I hold a insulation across this thing, okay, I hold a insulation across this test tube, then what will happen? The system will not transfer the heat to the surrounding. Cap is put on the test tube, so this system will not transfer the mass with the surrounding, or surrounding will not transfer the mass to the system. So heat also not transfer, mass also not transfer. But it is a possible, if I make such a provision, so it can transfer the work. Okay, but here insulation is there, cap is over the test tube, but it can take a work transfer across the boundary, then it is called as a closed system of insulated type. When I am removing the insulation, then we can say it is a non-insulated type closed system, okay, which can transfer the heat and work both. Okay, so this is a simple example I have put in front of you. Now here nowhere I had shown you how work can transfer. Okay, so here in the next slide I will tell you how work can transfer in case of the open, closed and the isolated system. Thank you.